Hey bastard, remember there is not such a thing as coincidence. If you're here, you deserve the best PvP build.
Gotcha, bitch!
Hello my beautiful bastards, Butcher in the building as usual, showcasing painful stuff.
To this day!
And one of the best builds in the game right now, this day is no exception, because I have for you PvP meta, and I'm not using Lady that fuck that gun.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Seriously, this build works much better without Lady Death, because we are using versatile talent. And maybe you have already used this talent, then you know that with switching hands you'll receive amplified weapon damage boost. And it works so damn good with SMG class and shotgun class, because you will get 35% amplified damage boosted. Simply ridiculous, brother. And we are using MP7. I tried it with Vector is really nice, don't get me wrong, it has a ridiculous rate of fire, but I feel on consoles that's not that good. Most of the time you will be reloading. And MP7 has really nice base damage value, and it hits like a truck. I would say it hits even harder than your ex-girlfriend, but this build absolutely shreds people left and right, and you can destroy heroic content without shield with this build as well. You heard me right, without using any shield whatsoever. I'm running trap, seeker mine, or maybe drone for distraction, it depends on your preference. But damage output is absolutely ridiculous. As you see, I'm using as well Hunter's Fury set, and basically with each kill we'll receive damage boost or damage stacks, and at the end output or DPS output is out of this world. Like I told you before, you can face tank everybody without shield, because Hunter's Fury set as well will give you armor back and 100% health back. So if you feel that you're gonna die soon, don't worry, don't lose your faith. One kill will get you back in the game, and honestly, I'm playing with heroic difficulty with directors applied, with no shield. This build slaps, because Hunter's Fury set by itself will amplify your damage. You have stacks from Hunter's Fury set, you have 35% amplified damage boost from versatile talent, and I'm running MP7 with Sadis, which will give us, of course, amplified 20% extra damage boost, so in total we have a ridiculous amount of damage. But before we continue, I just wanna let you know that we have some sponsor ads. And guys, if you don't have enough time or good teammates, but you still want to have all the best items in your game, then Leaving.net is set for you. They have absolutely amazing team on Xbox. They will complete your order twice as fast. Now everything happens with Akron sharing. This service has been working for many years. It has tons of customer reviews, you can check everything by yourself, but now with my promo code RBD, you will have 15% discount on all services. It's an amazing deal, especially when right now this site supports all riders. You can check everything by yourself, but if you have any questions, I will leave a link down below in my description. You can contact Deeming.net through the WhatsApp immediately. But now let's get back to my PvP build, which is better without Lady Death. And Lady Death will not work in this synergy, because you have to stack Lady Death by running, and unfortunately versatile will not give you that extra time to stack Lady Death. Versatile talent is unforgiving. You have 10 seconds, it is what it is, but in PvP with this time to kill, it's enough, it's more than enough. You can make 2 kills easily in 10 second window. Super dope synergy, and that's the reason why MP7 is absolutely beast. It has a better fire rate than Lady Death, and base damage absolutely much higher. And since Sadist is amplified weapon damage boost, difference will be not that high, but like I told you before, Lady Dead in this setup will not work, brother, will not work. Other than that, as you see, I'm slapping heroic content, and I would say for PvP, you have too much damage. Hunter's Fury set works so damn good in close range, and after kill, you will disorientate nearby enemies as well. You will have armor back, and my little dirty secret, of course, is a Rigvay's prized exotic chest piece, which will apply bleed effect left, right, and center. If you're gonna use Stinger, you have to boost this effect even further. You will be unkillable, because guys, with 5 enemies with status effect, in this case bleed effect on, you will have almost 50% armor regen. That's insane. Of course, in conflict, you have only 4 enemies, but this build works as well in DZ. So sometimes you will fight whole servers, and if you will be lucky enough, you can throw Stinger Hive into crowd, and you will be untouchable. And hey, if you want to be updated to all the best PvP, PvE builds, maybe subscribe. Definitely hit that like and share this video. So with no further ado, let's get into it. For specialization in PvP, you should use Fireball, because it's pretty broken, especially that flamethrower. But my little dirty secret in this build is, of course, Medkit from Firewall Specialization. If you're gonna pair it up with exotic Rigvay's Pride chest piece, which will apply bleed effect left, right, and center, and with that you will get armor regen as well, that's game over. This is the way how you can face tank multiple agents at once without shield. Super ridiculous synergy, brother. But for PV, I would recommend you to use Gunner Specialization, because on kill you will receive armor back and increased fire rate. Pretty dope synergy there, but my main weapon here is MP7 SMG. This baby hits extra hard with sadist on. It's amplified weapon damage boost, simply the best damage talent in the game right now. If your aim is better than mine, I would recommend you to use Vector SMG, because it has ridiculous rate of fire, but unfortunately on consoles that's not good option. But MP7 shreds people left, right, and center. Again, I'm taking couple agents at once without shield. Medkit strong regen is really handy, and don't forget that Hunter's Fury set on kill will basically give you 100% health back and 20% armor back as well. But for my second gun, I'm running FAMAS again with sadist. That's for mid-range fight, and Rigvay's Pride chest piece works in 15-meter radius, so pretty dope synergy there, and really, really nice assault rifle for pistol. I'm running Orbit Named Pistol with perfect finisher talent. You have to kill somebody with this gun, and then simply switch to your main weapon, and you will receive crit chance and crit damage boost. For the gear, everything, brother, is really simple. Hunter's Fury set is one of the best gear sets for DPS. For DPS in PvP and PvE, brother. Amplified weapon damage is outstanding. You're gonna confuse nearby enemies with those skills. And of course, sadist will... That's painful, ridiculous, funny, everything at the same time. And I would recommend you to find pieces with crit damage on them, so you could roll armor core attributes. Guys, crit chance is not a problem with SMG class, keep that in mind, so please find Hunter's Fury pieces with crit damage. For chest piece, I'm running Rigvay's exotic for chest piece, like I told you before million times, because Rigvay's for chest piece works so damn good with sadist. You have to just shoot and it will activate your sadist talent, and in our case it will give us, of course, armor regen. And I love this build so much because I don't have to use, of course, shield. And as you see, everybody is running those annoying shields, shield warriors all over the place, and I love much more dynamic gameplay. Run and gun with this build is absolutely ridiculous, and you don't have to worry about the broken animation, and shields will go down, and eventually it will go down and you will lose the precious time. And with this time to kill, it can be a really difference maker, and Then you have Seeker Mine, which will throw in stagger animation your enemies. You have Amplified Weapon Damage Boost, and on kill, you will basically confuse nearby enemies as well from Hunter's Fury set. You have Stinger High, which will apply bleed effect left, right, and center. And in that way, you will receive increased armor regen from Regress Sprite Chest Piece synergy all over the place. And I'm running Walking Harry's Backpack with Vash Style Talent again by switching guns. In this case, I will receive 35% Amplified Weapon Damage Boost for my SMG class and 10% for my Assault Rifle class. I could use, of course, Shotgun, maybe Super 90 Shotgun instead of Assault Rifle. Shotguns as well will receive Damage Boost, and Hunter's Fury set works really well with Shotguns, but I think Assault Rifle is a little bit better because you need gun for mid-range fights. And Shotgun is simply not worth it in my eyes in Conflict or DZ. So in PV, yeah, you could rock maybe Scorpio Shotgun, it depends on your preference. Scorpio, I think, will do the work, or Tsunami, but man, Shield will not work as well with Versatile Talent because you are losing that precious time when you pull that shield up, take it off. You have only 10 seconds. But like I told you before, that's plenty in Conflict. With this time to kill, you can easily get 2 kills with Hunter's Fury set. But unfortunately, if you're gonna use Shield, no, that's huge, no. You will be stuck with the broken animation again if you're gonna lose that shield. And Lady Death as well will not work in this set because you have to stack it before you will receive that maximum damage boost, and again you have only 10 seconds with Versatile Talent, so Lady Dead will not work in this build. So yeah, pretty much that's one of the best builds in the game right now. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.